TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Tuesday, the 3rd of September. Indian Air Force inducts 8 Apache attack helicopters. Imran Khan says Pakistan won't use nuclear weapons first. And U.S. Taliban reach agreement in principle on Afghanistan, says Khalilzad. And now for all the details. Indian Air Force on Tuesday inducted 8 Apache AH-64E attack helicopters at its northern Pathankot Air Base. The multi-role helicopters will give a major boost to the Air Force's combat powers.
The Indian Air Force, or IAF, on Tuesday inducted 8 Apache AH-64E attack helicopters at a ceremony at its Pathankot Air Base in northern Punjab province. The helicopters were given a water salute at the air base ahead of the induction. They are the first set of the intended 22 helicopters under a multi-billion dollar contract signed by India in 2015 with the US government and Boeing. Indian Air Force Chief Air Chief Marshal B.S. Dhanoa inducted the choppers officially into the service after a prayer ceremony conducted by clerics of different faiths. The multi-role Apache combat helicopters with air-to-air missile capability are known to be one of the fiercest in the world.
Today, with the induction of the Apache 864E, the IAF has upgraded its inventory to the latest generation of attack helicopters. Like it was covered by the CNC, we signed the contract in September 2015 to deliver 22 Apache helicopters, and these helicopters have been modified specifically to suit the exacting standards demanded by the IAF.
The attack helicopter has the capability to shoot and fire an advanced range of anti-tank guided missiles and other ammunition. It is also capable of escort and other heli-borne operations, separation of enemy air defense and battlefield airstrike roles. Earlier in March this year, Indian Air Force inducted Chinook helicopters in a series of advancements.
Amid tensions with arch rival India, Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan has said his country would never use nuclear weapons first. Khan asserted that both the nations are nuclear-armed countries, and if the tensions increase, the world could be in danger.
Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan said that his country would never use nuclear weapons first amid tensions with neighbouring India. Addressing members of the Sikh community at the International Sikh Convention on Monday in Lahore, Khan asserted both India and Pakistan are nuclear-armed countries, and if the tensions increase, the world could be in danger. Tensions between India and Pakistan heightened after New Delhi revoked the special status of Jammu and Kashmir and bifurcated it into two union territories.
دو نیوکلیئر آرم ملک ہیں اگر یہ آگے ٹینشنز بڑھتی ہیں تو دنیا کو خطرہ ہے اس سے تو میں نے آپ کے لیے صرف یہ اس لیے کہہ رہا ہوں کہ ہماری طرف سے کبھی بھی کوئی کسی طرف پہل نہیں ہوگی ہم کبھی بھی یہ جو سارا اس وقت جو سچویشن کھڑا ہوا ہوا کشمیر پہ یہ تو کوئی بھی ٹالریٹ نہیں کر سکتا جس پہ انسانیت ہے
Khan, in a joint sitting of Pakistan's parliament earlier, said that he would raise the Kashmir issue at every forum, including the UN Security Council, and also take the matter to the International Court of Justice. India has categorically told the international community that the scrapping of Article 370 of the Constitution to revoke the special status of Jammu and Kashmir was an internal matter.
Moving on, residents of Hunza Valley in Gilgit-Baltistan recently held a protest over severe water crisis in the illegally occupied region. They expressed their anger against Pakistan and said if the issue is not addressed soon, they will be forced to hold protest at a gateway of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor.
Scores of residents of Hunza Valley in Gilgit-Baltistan recently gathered to demonstrate over a serious water crisis in the region, which is making their lives miserable. The protesters expressed concerns that there is no water available for drinking as well as for other purposes, and demanded the authorities to immediately take action in the regard. They said that some people from the region have been going as volunteer laborers for the past 2 months to keep a check on the flow of water channels. And during such an occasion, a 72-year-old volunteer had to lose his life.
अगर हुकूमत ने अपनी जिम्मेदारी पूरी नहीं की तो आप देख रहे हैं हालत लोगों की. आज हम अगर चंद अफराद यहाँ पे चंद लोग मौजूद हैं तो कल ये हज़ारों में ये जलसे रैलियाँ तब्दील होंगी. और इस सीपेक के गेटवे के ऊपर मेरा नहीं ख्याल कि पाकिस्तान के लिए एक नेक शगुन या चाइना के लिए इवन नेक शगुन.
Protests in Gilgit-Baltistan have become a common sight with one or the other section of the society expressing its anger against Pakistan, which has always given a biased treatment to the illegally occupied region. Locals have long accused that since the launch of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor or CPEC, which passes through Gilgit-Baltistan, the region has been stripped away of its natural resources.
And in news from Afghanistan, U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad said the United States and the Taliban have reached an agreement in principle, but it is not final until U.S. President Donald Trump agrees on it. Khalilzad is in Afghan capital Kabul after completing 9 rounds of talks with Taliban representatives in Doha.
U.S. Special Representative for Afghanistan Reconciliation Zalmay Khalilzad has said that the U.S. and the Taliban have reached an agreement in principle, but it is not final until U.S. President Donald Trump agrees on it. While outlining details of a draft accord in a television interview on Monday, Khalilzad said that based on the draft agreement, the U.S. will withdraw 5,000 troops from 5 bases in Afghanistan within 135 days, if conditions in the agreement are addressed by the Taliban. Khalilzad, who is in Afghan capital Kabul after completing 9 rounds of talks with Taliban representatives, earlier held separate talks with Afghan government leaders, President Ashraf Ghani and Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah. Presidential spokesman Sadiq Siddiqui told reporters that the US-backed government will need to study and access details of the draft deal.
He talked about the details of that potential agreement, or framework of that agreement, that is going to be signed anytime in the future, near future. So we went through all those details, and the president had a look at the details, and he was briefed on how things worked and how he was pursuing that first phase that ended couple of days ago in Doha, and what is the next steps.
Meanwhile, as Khalilzad was outlining details of a draft accord in a television interview, a Taliban vehicle bomb exploded close to a residential area for foreign nationals and offices, which followed after major Taliban attacks on 2 northern cities over the weekend. At least 16 people were killed and 119 others, mostly civilians, were wounded in a truck bomb attack in Afghan capital Kabul on Monday evening.
And in news from Maldives, the Mali declaration adopted by the leaders at the South Asian Speakers Summit in the Maldives on Monday overlooked all assertions made by Islamabad on the Kashmir issue. The 2-day summit saw participation of senior lawmakers from Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Pakistan and Sri Lanka.
The 2-day-long South Asian Speakers Summit that adopted the Mali Declaration on Monday overlooked all assertions made by the Pakistani parliamentary delegation. India's position was prominently reflected, which included inter alia commitments to work collectively on promoting equality at work, including equal remuneration and creating jobs for young people. The Mali Declaration also pledged to work for nutrition and food security as drivers of maternal, child and adolescent health in the Asia-Pacific region, and overcoming challenges and utilizing opportunities to strengthen the regional agenda for delivering on the Paris Agreement. Indian and Pakistani delegation on the first day of the summit on Sunday got into a major war of words when Pakistan's delegate raised the issue of Jammu and Kashmir, strongly objecting to it India asserted that Jammu and Kashmir is an internal issue.
Hindu women in Nepal celebrated the festival of Hartalika Tij on Monday. Hindu devotees worship Lord Shiva and his consort Parvati on the occasion and celebrate by dressing up and dancing.
Hindu women in Nepal celebrated the festival of Hartalika Tij on Monday with fervor. Long queues of women dressed in red, green and yellow outfits were seen outside the famous Pashupatinath temple before they performed special prayers on the occasion. Tij is considered as one of the major festivals observed by married women in the country. To mark the occasion, women observe fast and offer prayers to Lord Shiva, the Hindu god of destruction, and his consort Parvati.
आमाहरु अब पहिलाका बुहारीहरुले दुःख पाउने त्यस्तो थियो हैन अनि यो तीजमा चाहिँ उनीहरु फुक्का हुने के पहिला आफ्नो कामहरु सकेर हामी चाहिँ अब माइत जानु पर्छ माइत जाने बस्ने उनीहरुको चाहिँ थकाई मार्ने चाहिँ छेडहरु नै तीज थियो के
On the festival of Tij, married women come to their parents' house and meet their childhood friends. They dance and sing together, which are considered means to express sorrow and joy. During this festival, women fast and pray for the health and well-being of their husband and family. Young unmarried girls pray that they will someday enjoy a happy marriage.
Around 4,000 Kashmiri youths on Tuesday attended the first day of a recruitment rally to join the Indian Army in India's Jammu and Kashmir. The candidates expressed enthusiasm over the opportunity for them to serve the nation.
Hundreds of Kashmiri youths attended an army recruitment rally in Riyasi district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday. On the first day of the recruitment rally, around 4,000 young aspirants turned up from Ramban and Kishtwar region of Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday. The candidates were subjected to physical measurements such as height, weight and chest before going through physical tests such as running, jumping and walking on a narrow ramp. They expressed it was an opportunity for them to join the armed forces to serve the nation.
आप खुद ही देख रहे हैं कि किस तरह से बच्चे और यहाँ के जो युवा हैं उत्साहित हैं देश की सेवा में जुड़ने के लिए भारतीय सेना से जुड़ने के लिए और भारतीय झंडे के नीचे काम करने के लिए
जो आर्मी है सबसे बेस्ट जॉब है और सबसे अच्छा यह है कि इसके करैक्टरिस्टिक्स और बिहेवियर बहुत अच्छा है और स्ट्रांग बनता है इंसान और जिसके कारण सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट यह है सर कि जैसे हम अपने माँ बाप की हिफाजत करते हैं उसी तरीके से हम अपने देश की हिफाजत करना चाहते हैं
Around 29,000 candidates have registered for the 9-day drive, army officials said. The candidates will be put to medical tests before the final recruitment. The recruitment drive aims to increase the representation of Jammu and Kashmir in the army and also help provide employment opportunities to the youth in the valley.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Indian Air Force inducts 8 Apache attack helicopters. Imran Khan says Pakistan won't use nuclear weapons first. And US Taliban reach agreement in principle on Afghanistan, says Khalilzad. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.